How about copyright? They're gonna copyright the fuck out of that portion of the video.
Okay, y'all, ignore that very annoying sound, but this is the whole outfit. My titties look so crazy.
This is one human experience I freaking despise.
Like, seriously,
you can't be serious.
This
my baby daddy, y'all. I'm pregnant.
Yeah.
Choose your fighter. Fight.
Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my channel. My name is Courtney, but I got my girl Kiki here on YouTube. And if you is new here, welcome to the family. Hey, hey, hey. If you is not new here, welcome back. How was you doing? I done missed you. Hope you are still staying safe out here in these streets. Okay, so today is Sunday. It is a gorgeous, gorgeous day outside. I just woke up like maybe 20 minutes ago. It's almost 11 o'clock. I didn't go to bed until really late. I didn't go to bed until like 5 something in the morning because I had took a really long nap. But I got my green juice here. I decided I'm just gonna get up and be productive today. I was off yesterday, Saturday. I'm off today and I'm off tomorrow. 3 days in a row being off. Ugh. That is a rare commodity when you work like 2-3 jobs. Like when you busy like I'm busy, that is rare. So yeah, my nails look all crazy. They've been falling off. This set has been trash. So I'm gonna try and order a better quality one because these were just little $12 press ons from the beauty supply store. So I'm gonna try and get some more. I actually have a party to go to later. My job, we're having our holiday party. Most big companies do it after the holidays because we were busy during the holidays. This looks so crazy. We were busy during the holidays. So we're having our holiday party today. So I just want to take you guys with me. I haven't seen you guys since my birthday. How have you been? No school tomorrow because it's Martin Luther King Day. So I don't have to work my day job. Tuesday, we're out because, well, they're having a remote learning day and I don't do speech therapy remotely. So it's another off day for me. So it's only a 3-day work week at my day job. Actually, I only got 3 days at both jobs. I got 3 night shifts and then 3 day shifts. So this is a really light week for me. Which is good because I made a lot of money last week. So I'm fine with that being a short week this week. So I'm about to do my morning routine. I already fed my cats. They're outside chilling. I opened the door for them so they could get outside a little bit. And then we are going to probably just do some work. I have just, one of my family members passed away yesterday. And so I have just really been like trying to evaluate like what's important to me, what I want to do, like what I want my life to look like, what kind of legacy I want to leave behind and stuff like that. So I just spent a lot of yesterday just like really thinking about life and like where I am and like, am I satisfied with it? The person who actually passed away was my Aunt Joanne. That was her name. She was actually my great aunt, but just call her my Aunt Joanne. She passed away yesterday, which is really sad because it was just so random because like I texted my cousin yesterday because y'all guess what? Why the fuck? Okay, let me explain real quick because this might sound kind of confusing. Okay, let's have a little therapy session real quick. I was not raised by my parents. I was raised by my great aunt and my great uncle. So I have my mom here, my dad here. My mom, trauma, mental health. My mom, okay. I was taken out of away. My custody was taken away from my mom. It was given to my great aunt. So my dad's mom's sister. So my great aunt raised me. I call her mom. I'm not close with my parents at all. They are literally not in my life whatsoever. So my great aunt is the one who raised me and her husband from literally the time that I was a baby. So my great aunt is really just my aunt to me. Like, it's not my great aunt. It's like, that's just my aunt. My great aunt who raised me, that's my mom. Like, my mom and my dad. Like, I call them my parents. So I got on TikTok, right? And it said my dad's name. It was like your dad, like one of your videos. I was like, hey, that's my dad's name. That person got the same name as my dad. Like, I was like, hold on, let me look. When I click on the profile, y'all, why my motherfucking daddy got a TikTok? Y'all, why my daddy got a TikTok? Listen, let me tell you something. My daddy is well into his 60s. first of all. Second of all, he don't know shit about technology. Who done taught this man how to get on TikTok and then like stuff? How he even find me? Like, when I tell you, me and my dad have never even texted before, like, to my knowledge, like, maybe a few times, like, in my entire life. He is not a technologically advanced person at all. Like, when I tell you, when I used to live at home, Courtney, can you come help me? Courtney, come help me set up this printer. Courtney, come help me set up my phone, please. Help me set up my voicemail, please, Courtney. Like, and you on TikTok? Like, that shit really, like, blew me. Like, I'm just like, daddy, please get off my TikTok. I cannot, not my daddy being on my, oh Lord, why am I so embarrassed right now? Like, dad, get off of my shit. Like, what are you doing right now? Like, if I'm out of my family's watch my YouTube video or anything, like, I'm just embarrassed. Like, stop. Like a kid. Like, don't look at that. I don't post the most appropriate things on my TikTok and shit. Oh, go follow me on TikTok, by the way. It's Young and Kinky with like 3-4 Y's. It's always down in the description box below. He liked one of my videos. And then I text my cousin. And I was like, girl, why is daddy on TikTok? Who helped him? And then she just was like, oh, yeah. And my aunt passed away. And I was like, what the fuck? Like, and it was so crazy because I was just thinking about her the other day. Like, so then I'm just sitting here like, I don't know. Because it's so hard to explain to people to get to, like, convey a message. Like, me and my parents weren't really that close growing up. Like, we butted heads a lot. So I really don't know if me trying to build something when I'm almost in my 30s and they're in their 60s is worth it. Does that make sense to y'all? Like, is it worth trying to, like, make something out of something that wasn't there when I was growing up? Like, this nice, happy relationship between my parents was not there growing up. And it's the reason why I have no problem moving to damn Timbuktu, packing up and leaving and not really being concerned. But I did stay on the East Coast so I could be close to my parents, because if my aunt, she's not, apparently, from what I know, that she's not having the funeral. But they are doing, because they're going to cremate her. And so I guess they're just going to have a viewing. And I'm sad that I can't be there, but I can't really afford a plane ticket right now to go all the way home and, you know what I'm saying, take off work and all the other stuff. But if there was a funeral, I would have found a way. I probably would have had to drive. Dang, my license expired now. Shit. Anyways. So I'm just like, I think I want to be closer to my family, but I just don't want to do it and it be in vain. Like, this, I hope that makes sense to y'all. Like, my parents raised me, you know, my great uncle, my mom, my dad, that's what I call them. They raised me. I love them to death. But, like, we are not a very affectionate household. We were not close. I'm just like, I don't want to pick up and move. I wouldn't move back home. I would just move closer to home. I'm thinking, like, the DMV area, like D.C., maybe Northern Virginia, if you're familiar with that area. But more so D.C., but I have a lot, like, I really love Atlanta. Like, I loved it living down here. I love the blackness. I love the black excellence. Every person I meet has a side hustle going on. This is a city of fucking hustlers, and it motivates the fuck out of me to want to do better. Like, there's so many different opportunities down here for black people, specifically, I feel like, black business owners to succeed, because you can network with anybody and you can meet anybody. Like, this is the black freaking Mecca. Like, this is black Hollywood. They call it that for a reason. So I just don't know if DC is the right fit for what I'm trying to do right now, but I'm thinking about it, because my aunt that passed away, I can't remember if she was older or younger than my mom, but it just made me think about my mom. Like, they're freaking the same, around the same age, and it's just like, I can't do this. Like, I never had to grieve anybody before. I've never had to. I just cannot. Like, this is one human experience I freaking despise. Like, I would rather go through anything, any trauma other than grief. I don't want to do this, but I don't have a choice. Anyways, I'm trying not to let that affect my entire weekend. I'm trying to use that to motivate me to want to do better and live better. So I woke up this morning and I'm like, I need you to work on your business, Courtney. Because there's a lot of things that I'm trying to accomplish, and I'm tired of struggling, and I'm tired of feeling like I'm behind the curve, feeling like I'm being left behind. Like, I'm tired of it. Like, I've been watching all these shows and stuff, and about, like, people who invented, it's a show on the History Channel, and it's basically called, like, Fools That Built America. And it's all these stories about these entrepreneurs who literally bet on themselves to the very freaking end. I'm talking about, like, it's so inspiring. Like, they bet their last freaking dollar on they self, and that shit worked out. I'm talking about the people who invented Taco Bell, McDonald's, Arby's, KFC, Fritos, Lay's, how Frito and Lay came together, how Pepsi and Cola came together. Like, that shit is just so inspiring. Like, when you really look at these people, and most of that shit was built out of the Great Depression. Like, people had nothing, and they literally made something out of nothing. If that shit don't motherfucking light a fire on your ass, like, for example, the CEO or the founder of the company that I work for, not gonna say the name of it if you haven't deduced that by now, but the company that I work for, we were learning in my orientation about, like, the CEO, and this is a major, I know I work at a hotel, it's a major hotel, you could probably guess which one it is. The CEO or the founder, way back when, I feel like it was during the Great Depression, he had his hotel, I think he only had one or a few hotels, his freaking bellhop gave him his life savings, which at the time probably was like maybe $100, I don't know, it probably was something like that. He gave him his life savings to keep the hotel afloat. So the hotel went and closed during the Great Depression. And now it is a multi-billion dollar worldwide freaking recognized brand. Can you imagine? Can you freaking imagine, like, or you see the stories on these shows of, like, how they kept failing and failing and failing and failing and failing and had literally, was millions of dollars in debt, had every reason to give up, and they did not. I can't do it, bro. Like, the last time I went home and I saw my mom, like, I hadn't seen her in a while, and it's like, when I looked at her face, like, she looked so old. Like, she just looked like she had gotten so much older since the last time she saw her, and I'm like, damn, she did. And so, like I said, I don't want to move back home per se, but I do want to be closer to home. So I either want to be closer to my house, or I want to be able to go back home more often. So just be able to afford a flight, because a flight from here to VA is only like $200. I feel like if you got it last minute, like, it'd probably be like $300-$400, but I want to be able to afford that so I can keep going home more often. So I'm thinking about it. It's just that if I move to DC, it's only gonna be like a 2-3 hour drive max, like, or is it 4 hours? I'm thinking about it, guys. I just wanted to, like, just catch y'all up about what's been going on and what's been going through my mind lately. So let's go ahead and get this morning routine started.
Feel free to skip any poses that don't feel right or modify if and when needed. We'll begin laying, getting a really big stretch. Perfect. We'll go ahead and interlace our fingers or grab opposite elbows, taking the upper body towards the top left corner of the mat and the feet towards the bottom left corner for a supine banana pose.
Kelly Bay, she's so cute.
this way.
See, I'm just sitting at my desk working. I've been over here for probably like, I don't know, maybe a little bit under an hour. I've been sitting over here. Right now, I am working on getting all of my products onto my website so I can start selling them. Still working on certain stuff. So right now, I'm just working on my, make it smaller. Just working on my About Me page. This is for my Ultimate Business Branding Kit. So it's for building your brand and brand identity. Perfect for business owners, new business owners, companies looking to rebrand, companies looking to need brand clarity, and creators looking to bring their content. And then it just goes into it a little bit down there, a little sneak peek. But yeah, I'm just working on that. I'm hungry. I have not eaten anything at all, but I'm trying to hold off till like lunch or something. How about copyright? They're gonna copyright the fuck out of that portion of the video. I forgot to turn the music off. But yeah, this is what I've just been working on. Just been sitting over here. It's like 1 o'clock, it's a little bit after one, it's 1:06. Actually, hey, birthday tweet, 1:06, babe. So yeah, I'm just gonna be over here for a couple of hours working, and then I will probably take a break and eat lunch and stuff like that. And then as far as the party, I'm literally waiting on some Amazon packages to come. We'll open those together later. But I'm waiting on some stuff to come in from Amazon because I needed some stuff for my outfit. I ordered some rings and some bangles, but they won't be here till fucking tomorrow, which is really making me mad. What I need to do also, I need to redo my lashes and fix my nails because they look freaking horrendous. I was gonna get another set from the beauty supply store, but I'm gonna just stick with these. Are so cheap, I hate them so much. But I mean, they're cute, but like they're really cheap. Like they were literally just breaking in half. Like they are not sturdy at all. So if you have a personal nail business or you know somebody who sells personal nails, please leave their information down in the comments down below. Because I'm looking to start testing out, because honestly, you guys know that, well, if you don't know, I have my own cosmetic company. We launched in 2019, but I just did not do it right at all, and honestly, it got put on the back burner. So I decided to focus on that probably the next fiscal year, the next business year. This business year, I'm just focused on Young and Kinky, my digital products, you know, my drop shipping store, stuff like that, my website, and then my social media. And then once I feel like I have that stuff on autopilot and that I have enough time, then I'm gonna relaunch my cosmetic, right? That's what all this crap is over here sitting over here. It's literally like products. It's, you can even see some lashes down there at the bottom. I actually use the cell press on nails. I'll try and insert some pictures if I can find any of the nails that I was testing out. I never actually got to my wholesale order process, but I see that there are a lot of wholesalers who do press on nails, so I kind of want to start testing them out just so I can start trying to find somebody who can, you know, wholesale my nails, because I don't want those little cheap ass plastic machine made press on nails. Like I want good quality handmade press on nails. Like, yeah. So anyways, if you know anybody, leave them down in the description box below. I mean, leave them down in the comments below. Yeah, I'm just, like I said, I'm just working on this for right now, and then I'll probably take a break and then do my lashes and my nails and stuff, and then eat. I wanted to go to the store because I don't expect to have company tonight, but I did clean the house up yesterday and stuff like that. I did want to go get some juice, and I wanted to go to the liquor store and get a bottle of Douce, because like I said, we have our holiday party tonight, but we were talking about like turning up afterwards, like I'm a little at the party because it's a freaking hotel. So we're just going to get some rooms and just probably just chill in the room, play games, drink, stuff like that. Just turn up. Just have a little good time. Turn up. We've been so busy all year and we worked really hard. And I feel like this is a great time to just celebrate that hard work with your teammates, with your team members, the people who you fuck with. Because I fuck with all my coworkers. It's surprising, but I fuck with all my coworkers. Everybody just cool with everybody. So we finna turn the fuck up. But I really also don't feel like leaving the house because I'm kind of just stuck to my desk right now. It's 1 o'clock. I still have like hours worth of work to do. So I don't know, because the party starts at 7, I think. I think it's either 7 to 11 or 8 to 11. I think that it's 8 to 11. But I was going to start getting ready at like 7, 8 o'clock. I'm not really in a rush to get there because it's go to 11. So I'm probably not going to try and get there until like 9-ish, maybe 8:39. No. For whatever reason, I just don't want to be there on time. But
what's up, y'all? It's like 7:45. I do not want to go to this fucking party. I fixed my nails. I fixed them, and I did my lashes. Hello, do you like them? Still trying to figure out what lash map I like the best. I don't even think I did the same on each eye, but I think they're cute. I really like them. I just love the convenience of being able to do my own lashes and my own nails. Got somewhere to go. I don't gotta make no appointment. I don't gotta wait in no line. I don't gotta spend hours at no shop. I can just do my shit at home. Ow! If y'all are interested, I can do a video on how to do your own lashes at home because it is really fucking easy. If you know how to put regular lashes on, you can put these on.
I really don't feel like going. And I was going to tell my coworkers, like, I don't really want to go. Like, I don't want to go. I'm, like, so comfy. I'm in my PJs. I'm all moisturized and supple and shit. And now these motherfuckers need me to get up and go all the way to the... I got to call an Uber. Spend at least $20 to get to this hotel. And then, I don't know. It's going to be... It's just so awkward. Like, it just feel like... If a bitch trying to run this mirror, let me know, okay? If a bitch trying to run this mirror and I ain't looking, y'all better let me know. I'm sorry, I play too much. But I just feel like it's going to be like a little fashion show. Like, everybody want to be all cute in front of their coworkers. And this is how I dress outside of work. And I'm so... And I just don't feel like participating. But my manager literally said that we better go to this holiday party because he gave us the whole, like, he basically had a whole restaurant the day off. Like, I don't know what the how they're surviving right now. Don't really give a fuck. But he was like that. I gotta stay fly until I die.
I gotta stay.
Why did I come in here? Oh, don't play with it. Come on, baby. Don't play with it. Just lay in it. Man, I'm just wanted to put on my primer before I started putting on my clothes so it can have time to dry. And I saw this. My shopping bags from when I went shopping last weekend are still in my closet. In my linen closet. I have not at all unpacked them. Okay, it's my first time using this primer, the milk primer. Somebody commented on my last video too and said they used it on their bare face. I feel like I could see this product doing that. It's squirted on my face. But I do got other coworkers going, so I'm like, you know what? Oh, this smell good. Fragrancy, but it smells good. Hold on, I gotta turn around. But I heard this primer was like really good. So I'm doing my makeup and stuff. I'm doing a full face. Probably pick the camera back up after I'm done getting ready. The party is over at 11. Like I said, it's about 8:00 now. I feel like I won't really trying to get there till like 9:30 because I'm not trying to be there that long. I'm gonna take some stuff just in case I stay the night because I feel like we can get a room if we want to. It's a fucking hotel. They give us rooms all the time. But I'm taking some overnight clothes just in case I get too fucked up or in case somebody want to do something afterwards and they get a room or something. I just don't want to not have it and they need it. But I'm going to be taking my little whole bag, basically. My little spend night bag. And I was bringing some games. We're supposed to be playing games, but we got a group chat. And I texted the group chat, like, who's still going? Nobody responded. So I'm like, if I show up to this bitch and don't nobody come, I swear to God, I ain't fucking my coworkers no more. Because I could have stayed in my bed. Because all them bitches got cars. They have cars. So they can drive up to that bitch and drive home. I got to take an Uber in heels. Let me get dressed, y'all. Totally forgot I was vlogging. Yeah. But this is my finished look. This is the dress. I wish I had a better angle. But this is the dress. It's like super long. I bought this chain separately. This is what I was going on from Amazon because it was just giving real plain. Real plain. You know what I'm saying? I put flakes wraps in my hair. It didn't turn out great, but I wanted to do an updo anyway. I wouldn't look too crazy on camera. But yeah, then I just got on this overcoat because I gotta go downstairs in my locker because I'm bringing some stuff just in case I need to stay the night or I get too fucked up and I feel like I can't get home safely. Then I bought some stuff to stay. Plus, a bunch of my coworkers said they wanted to stay anyway, but now everybody's saying they're not going. I'm so mad. If my coworkers don't come to this motherfucking party after they done convinced me to come to this guy after I said I wasn't going, I really said, no, I ain't going to no damn holiday party. Like, I don't want to see y'all motherfuckers outside. But my coworkers said, no, come. We're going to have fun. We're going to turn up afterwards. We're going to blow fucking blah. And now nobody wants to show up. So, my lift is like 2 minutes away. So, I'm going to go outside and meet them. And I will see y'all at the party. I see y'all at the party. Can a nigga catch a break? Give a pretty brown girl her space. You can keep your minute. I'ma make a bet. Hey, already got the world on me. Give a pretty brown girl her space. You can keep your minute. I'ma make a better way. Hey, hey, nigga, catch a break. Okay, y'all, ignore that very annoying sound, but this is the whole outfit. My titties look so crazy. This is the outfit. That looks so cute. Okay, let's go find this party because I actually don't know what ballroom it's in. Oh, they play good music. Hold on. Hey. Hey. Hey, hey.
let's get a turn. Let's get a spin. Yes, bitch. Yes.
Seriously,
you can't be serious. This is my baby daddy, y'all. I'm pregnant.
Yeah. We're gonna get a little under the bed.
What? He African, I don't be understanding everything.
Yeah, how a baby gonna be looking like it under the bed?
Our baby gonna be dark.
Yeah, under the bed. He's dark, right?
Must be an African thing. Anyways, we should sit at the bar. Should I show that a bar? Trying to figure out what the fuck we're
going to
do next.
Waiting on Tay. Hey. You're a rock star. Where are you going? What's up? Come on.
C'est bon?
Baby.
What's up, baby?
It was both.
We got it. Hey.
Hey. Come here. Come here, Mike. Okay, never mind.
Mike, you got your own ass over here.
Yeah. Come on, Mike. Dom. You hear me, nigga? You got it.
Okay, all right. Cheers. Clean.
Take. She knew nothing.
I'm not taking that. Okay, y'all. I'm pretty fucked up right now. I'm a little tipsy. But they end up giving us a room. Mini tour. They end up giving us a little room or whatever. I'm so excited. Let's see the view. It's so pretty. Open it up, baby. Open it up. Ooh, it's so pretty. So, yeah, we finna go to a hookah bar in a different part of town. We finna turn the fuck up. It is 1:11. The place closes at 3, so we're fine. I'm gonna leave all of my stuff here. I look, I'm gonna take this water. I'll leave here more for when I get back. I got games and shit, but we'll probably be too fucked up. But I'm gonna use the bathroom and then I gotta meet my ride downstairs because I took an Uber here. Y'all know I got no car, I did not drive. So let's go.
Happy New Year.
Not Happy New Year.
Are they some shots? Good.
Not really nice.
Y'all, it's literally like 6:00 in the morning. It's like 5:45 and we just not get back to the hotel. That was a lot of fun, but I'm fucking exhausted. Y'all, first off, look at my damn eyelashes. They stuck to my damn eye. I was not the fuck. They look crazy now. Y'all.
Oh, Lord Jesus. So it's literally like 5:15.
Okay, so I had to go do something real quick. So it's about 5:30, y'all. Whew. I don't have no Gatorade or no ginger ale, so I just grabbed one of these. It's, can you see? Strawberry kale. It's a little fruit juice. But it's not really fruit juice. It's vegetable juice. It's not bad. It just tastes like watered down strawberry juice. I need some electrolytes or something, child. I just feel very, you know how you feel after you drink. Real weak. Oh my God, y'all. So after I put, yes. So y'all saw when I came back to the hotel yesterday. Oh, I don't like this anymore. So I got back to the hotel around almost 6:00 in the morning. We had the holiday party, and then we went to an after party, and then we went to an after hour spot after that. That's my first time doing that. Like, I've never been to an after hour spot. When I tell you, like, first of all, let me back up. Let me tell y'all why I don't fuck with these fucking, oh my God, this is my first time. I've been to the clubs, but I've never been out that late. And oh my God. So we go to the, we trying to find the after party that all my coworkers, everybody was like, okay, we're gonna meet at, it's called Harold's Ice Bar. None of us have never been there before. So it was confusing because it was in like a shopping center. Across the shopping center on this side where we had went to, they said like Harold's, I guess it was a restaurant. It said Harold's restaurant. And so we was over there and I was like, I don't think it's supposed to be over here. So I look behind me and I see that it's a Harold's Ice Bar. I'm like, we got to go over there. We get in the car, we drive to the other side of the shopping center, and we actually end up going to the wrong place. Cause we get to the door and the man was like, it's 30 and up. And none of us was 30. Like we was like, none of us is 30. Like, why would they tell us to go to a club that's 30 and up? And so the man was like, the security. He was like, I can't really let y'all in. And then my coworker's trying to be like, look, can you just like, we just trying to meet our coworkers here. Like, can we just slide you a little something? You let us in. And he was like, I don't know. I can't really, let me go see. So then this other nigga came out. He was like, what y'all doing out here? And he was like, I work here. What y'all trying to get in? We was like, yeah, we not 30. He was like, come on, I got y'all. So, cause that was finna close anyway. So we end up going in there. We didn't pay no money to get in there. The man was just like, all right, come on. We go in there. That shit, I can't even remember what was going on in there. Oh, what's happening there? Nothing for real. We was just like, where everybody at? Like, where the rest of our coworkers at? I broke a fucking nail yesterday in the hotel room too. But he was like, where everybody at? Why would they tell us to go to a club that's turning up? And then it was closing because it was like 3:00 at that point. It was closing. So we end up, I can't remember what we end up doing, but I think we was leaving. We went outside to go find everybody. And I looked next door. We was actually in a place next door to Harold's Ice Bar. Mind you, one of my coworkers, he was lagging. And so he came in a little bit after us. Why the fuck did that man charge him $60 to get in? And I was talking to my coworker, the dark skinned guy that was beside me in the previous video. He charged him $60 to get in to a club that was closing in like 30 minutes anyway. And when he told me that, he was like, yeah, he charged me $60. I said, that nigga did what? He charged you what? Like, who does shit like that? Like, I feel like he took advantage because the dark skinned guy, he is not American. Like, he's from Africa. Specifically, he's from Burkina Faso, which I believe is west of Ghana, is right by Ghana. But he don't know. Like, you not fuck. What the fuck? Like, I was like, I would have half my to go cuss that security guard out. I got, because he did it through Cash App. So I just disputed the charge. I said it was a scam. Who does that? Like, $60 for a club that's literally about to. I said, oh, baby, he got you. And I said, you need to request your money back. So then he went to the guy, and then they started like, I'm like, why the fuck would you? No, like, what the hell? So we ended up going to the next spot next door. We was originally supposed to be any motherfucking way. And I was looking at the security guard. I was like, why you let us come in here knowing that we was in the wrong spot anyway? He was like, I was trying to tell y'all, no, bitch, you were not. You're trying to scam. For $60, you broke, nigga. I hope you, bitch. Like, I hope somebody know that, nigga. Like, don't do that. Don't, like, the club literally was closed at that point. Like, when we were in there, like, it was closed. Like, they had light turned on and everything. Like, why would you charge him $60 again? I hope they shut your fucking Cash App down. You fucking scamming ass bitch. Like, that shit made me so mad. Because I'm just like, he don't know better. He's not from here. You literally
tried to get over somebody who literally don't know better. Like, for $60, bitch, like, your job gonna pay you enough that you gotta scam people? Like, you're not even a door person, you're a security person. Which is what I'm just like, he really got that nigga. Like, so we ended up going to the spot next door, and they was having drinks. I was done. I didn't need nothing more to drink at that point. So they was drinking and stuff. We was just in there. And so then that place was closing. Because we was just in there because one of my coworkers was cool with, like, the management or whatever. So they let us in, like, after hours. We was just chilling in there. So then that place was closing. So then we go to the next place, which is in the same shopping center. We go to the next place, which was, like, after hours. And then we ended up standing there for, like, an hour or two. Like, it was crazy. It was super dark in there. I did that video that was super dark. Like, that's where we was. Like, that was after hours. But maybe I was just, we was turned up. We was turned the fuck up. So we finally decided, okay, we're ready to go back to the hotel. We go back to the hotel, and they gave us rooms. Like, they gave everybody a room. And so I had my own room. My coworkers had their own room and stuff like that. And I went in that room, and I was knocked the fuck out. It was literally, like, 6 o'clock when I went to bed. I was like, I'm finna be so tired because checkout is at 11. Man, I woke up, guys. I was so sick this morning. Like, I hate throwing up. That's why like, I don't even, like, when I throw up after drinking, I don't even have to be drunk. I don't even have to have had that much to drink. I could have a glass of wine, I could have two shots, and I'll throw up everywhere. I don't know what the fuck. If anybody else got that, can y'all let me know? Because I be feeling like it's something wrong with me. Like, I don't get drunk. I got drunk one time in my life, and I never got drunk ever since. Like, I might have gotten to the, I'm talking about drunk, like, when you just, like, you don't know what's going on, like, that kind of drunk. I only been that kind of drunk one time, and unfortunately, something not so great happened, or almost happened, and I say I will never do that again. I will never be so fucked up that I don't know what's going on in my surroundings again. So, I don't get that drunk, but I don't know what I was drinking last night. Like, I literally just had my coworkers, because I mean, we work in a restaurant, they're bartenders. I was just like, just make me something, like, just bring me something, like, just, it don't even matter. So I don't know what the fuck I was drinking. I thought I was drinking tequila and vodka all night, but apparently something else got thrown in the mix, because baby, I was fucked up. Emma was smoking too. I was fucked up. So this morning I woke up, I was so freaking sick. Like, I was so sick. Like, I was throwing everywhere. Like, I was so freaking sick. I was like, I'm all the way to this hotel, I gotta get home. Like, then the bill's knocking the door, like, it's time to check out. Like, I was like, all right, give me like 20 more minutes. I laid back there, then I got up, and I was like, okay, I'm good. Like, nope, threw up some more. And I came home, and I just felt so, then my Uber driver, oh, it seemed like every bump and fucking pothole in the road that made the car bounce was just making me feel so freaking sick. So I was just like, Courtney, please don't throw up in this lady's car, because she's gonna say that you ruined her car, and then you're gonna have to pay the cleaning fee. I ain't got time. So I got home, had to make it all the way upstairs. I literally threw my stuff that's my shit from last night. I literally threw my shit on the couch and just, like, closed all my blinds and curtains and passed out in the bed. Like, put my trash can by me, and I just passed the fuck out. And that was at, like, it had to be around 12 that I came home and went to sleep, and I just got up at, like, 5 something, so I was knocked the fuck out. Now I'm starving. I'm really hungry. I haven't eaten anything. Obviously, I couldn't keep anything down. And so I'm just going to have this. And I want some Mexican food. So I was thinking about DoorDash or something. It's a place right next door. And I was going to walk there. But I don't feel like leaving my house today at all. Like, I didn't know I was going to sit in the house. But yeah, that was honestly, other than me being sick this morning, that was a lot of fun. Like, ooh, my coworkers. They know how to... They know how to party. I'm so glad I went, because I almost did go. I will go, but that shit was, it was a lot of fun. It was definitely something to remember. Like, this is honestly a job where I fuck with all my coworkers, and everybody's just so cool, where everybody, like, there's no beef, there's no drama. Like, we could literally get into a whole argument, and then the next day we're going to be cool again, because we just have, like, a team. I don't think I've ever really experienced that before, like, at a job, and I've been working for 12 years. Like, when you genuinely fuck with your coworkers, like, for real, fuck with them, like, that's crazy. I'm finna probably take a goddamn shower, because I'm gross. I don't even know what I'm doing with my hair, if I'm wrapping it or pin curling it. But yeah, I'll probably just go ahead and take a shower, put my hair up. Well, unpack my bag and stuff like that. And then I'll probably work on my computer, so, because I'm almost finished with my website. Remember I showed y'all earlier, I'm almost finished getting the products up, so I'm so excited to get my digital products up. So that's almost finished. I'm gonna work on that probably for a couple hours. I'm just DoorDash some Mexican food or Chick-fil-A, one of the two. I could do Chick-fil-A or I could do Mexican food. Which one should I have? What's best post hangover? Anyways, thank you all so much for watching today's video. I hope you all enjoyed it. I hope it was a little entertaining. Please don't forget to smash that red subscribe button down below. Show your girl some love. And follow me on social media at Young and Kinky, because let's be friends. Duh. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. And I will see y'all in next week's vlog. Okay? Bye. Oh, wait. My bad. I'm so ignorant. Happy freaking Martin Luther King Day. Happy Martin Luther King Day. Okay, bye.